Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Causal Impact package created by Google estimates the impact of an intervention on a time series. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to tune the hyperparameters of the time series causal impact model using the Python package CausalImpact. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import the Python libraries. Firstly, let's install CausalImpact for time series causal analysis. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. Pandas, NumPy, and DataTime are imported for data processing. ArmA process is imported for synthetic time series data creation. Matplotlib and Seaborn are for visualization. CausalImpact is for time series treatment effects estimation. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic time series dataset for the causal impact analysis. The ground truth of the causal impact is usually not available. The benefit of using a synthetic dataset is that we can validate the accuracy of the model results. The causal impact package requires two types of time series: a response time series that is directly affected by the intervention, and one or more control time series that are not impacted by the intervention. The idea is to build a time series model to predict the counterfactual outcome. In other words, the model will use the control time series to predict what the response time series outcome would have been if there had been no intervention. In this example, we created one response time series variable and two control time series variables. To make the dataset reproducible, a random seed is set at the beginning of the code. Then an autoregressive moving average process is created. For the first control time series variable x1, the autoregressive part has two coefficients 0.95 and 0.04, and the moving average part has two coefficients 0.6 and 0.3. A constant value of 10 is added to the autoregressive moving average process. For the second control time series variable x2, the autoregressive part has two coefficients 0.85 and 0.01, and the moving average part has two coefficients 0.7 and 0.2. A constant value of 20 is added to the autoregressive moving average process. After setting the autoregressive moving average coefficients, 5,000 samples are generated for x1 and x2. The response time series variable y is a function of the control time series variables. It equals 10 times x1 plus 2 times x2, then plus a random value. The intervention happens at the index of 3,000, and the true causal impact is 20. A time series usually has a time variable indicating the frequency of the data collected. We created 5,000 dates beginning on January 1, 2000 using the pandas date range function. Freq equals d indicates the dataset has daily data. After that, a pandas data frame is created with the control variable x1, x2, the response variable y, and the index dates. In step 3, we will set the pre- and the post-intervention periods. We can see that the time series start date is 2000-01-01, the time series end date is 2013-09-08, and the treatment start date is 2008-03-19. Next, let's visualize the time series data. In the chart, the blue line is the first control time series, the orange line is the second control time series, and the green line is the response time series. The Python causal impact package requires the pre- and the post-intervention periods to be specified. In our dataset, the intervention starts on the 3000 first day, so the pre-intervention time period includes the first 3000 days, and the post-intervention time period includes the last 2000 days. That corresponds to the start date of 2000-01-01 and end date of 2008-03-18 for the pre-period, and the start date of 2008-03-19 and end date of 2013-09-08 for the post-period. In step 4, we will execute the causal impact analysis on the time series with default hyperparameters. The causality analysis has two assumptions. Assumption 1, there are one or more control time series that are highly correlated with the response variable, but not impacted by the intervention. Violation of this assumption can result in wrong conclusions about the existence, the direction, or the magnitude of the treatment effect. Assumption 2, the correlation between the control and the response time series is the same for pre- and post-intervention. The synthetic time series data we created satisfy the two assumptions. The Python causal impact package has a function called causalImpact that implements a Bayesian structural time series model on the backend. It has three required inputs. Data takes the Python data frame name. Pre-period takes the starting and the ending index values for the pre-intervention period. Post-period takes the starting and the ending index values for the post-intervention period. After saving the output object in a variable called impactDefault, we can run impactDefault.summary to get the results summary. The summary results tell us that the absolute causal effect is 20.64, which is close to the true causal impact of 20. The 95% confidence interval for the absolute causal effect is -28.47 to 70.81. To learn more about the causal impact function, please check out my tutorial time series Causal Impact Analysis in Python. In step 5, we will talk about how to tune the hyperparameter niter for causal impact. Niter is the number of MCMC samples. Bayesian inference usually needs at least 1,000 samples to get reasonable results. The default value for niter in the causal impact package is 1,000, and we changed it to 3,000. The results show an absolute effect of 20.64, which is the same as the default hyperparameter estimation. The confidence interval is slightly wider at -31.96 to 73.1. In step 6, we will talk about how to tune the hyperparameter standardized data for causal impact. Standardized data is a Boolean value indicating whether to standardize all the time series before fitting the model. The default value is true. In this example, we set the standardized data equals false. The results show the absolute effect of 20.64, which is the same as the default hyperparameter estimation. The confidence interval is slightly wider at -28.79 to 72.11. In step 7, we will talk about how to tune the hyperparameter prior level SD for causal impact. Prior level SD is the prior local level Gaussian standard deviation. The default value for prior level SD is 0.01. This default value usually works well for stable time series with low residual volatility after controlling covariates. When there is uncertainty about the stability of the data, the causal impact package documentation suggests setting prior level SD to 0.1 as a safer option. But this option may lead to very wide prediction intervals. When setting prior level SD equals none, the Python stats metal package does the optimization for the prior on the local level component. The CausalImpact documentation strongly recommends setting the prior level SD as none when using the Python version of the package. The summary results for prior level SD equals 0.1 tell us that the absolute causal effect is 21.22, which is slightly higher than the true causal impact of 20. The 95% confidence interval for the absolute causal effect is -510.08 to 522.41, which is much wider than the confidence interval from the default values. The larger prior level SD produced worse results than the default value, probably because true prior level SD is quite different from 0.1. Next, let's set prior level SD to none. The summary results for prior level SD equals none tell us that the absolute causal effect is 20.08, which is very close to the true causal impact of 20, and better than the default hyperparameter result. The 95% confidence interval for the absolute causal effect is 20.01 to 20.14, which is much narrower than the default hyperparameter result. In step 8, we will talk about how to tune the hyperparameter nseasons for causal impact. Nseasons specifies the seasonal components of the model. The default value is 1, meaning that there is no seasonality in the time series data. Changing the value to a positive integer greater than 1 automatically includes the seasonal component. For example, nseasons equals 7 means that there is weekly seasonality. Currently, the causal impact package only supports one seasonal component, but we can include multiple seasonal components using the Bayesian structural time series model and pass the fitted model in as BSDS.model. In this example, we will set the hyperparameter nseasons equals 7 to include weekly seasonality. The summary results tell us that the absolute causal effect is 20.65, which is slightly higher than the true causal impact of 20. The 95% confidence interval for the absolute causal effect is -33.65 to 71.83, which is wider than the confidence interval from the default values. Since the synthetic dataset does not include seasonality, there is no obvious improvement in the estimation results. But this hyperparameter should give better results for the time series with weekly seasonalities. In step 9, we will talk about how to tune the hyperparameter seasonal duration for causal impact. Seasonal duration specifies the number of data points in each season. The default value for seasonal duration is 1. For example, nseasons equals period 7, seasonal duration equals 1 means that the time series data has weekly seasonality, and each data point represents one day. If we would like to include the monthly seasonality, nseasons needs to be set to 12 and seasonal duration needs to be set to 30, indicating that every 30 days represent one month. In this example, we will use nseasons equals period 12, seasonal duration equals 30 for the hyperparameters. The summary results tell us that the absolute causal effect is 20.62, which is slightly higher than the true causal impact of 20. The 95% confidence interval for the absolute causal effect is -29.16 to 72.13, which is slightly wider than the confidence interval from the default values. Since the synthetic dataset does not include seasonality, there is no obvious improvement in the estimation results. But this hyperparameter should give better results for the time series with monthly seasonalities. In step 10, we will talk about how to tune the hyperparameter dynamic regression for causal impact. Dynamic regression is a Boolean value indicating whether to include time-varying regression coefficients. Since including a time-varying local trend or a time-varying local level often leads to overspecification, this hyperparameter defaults to false. We can manually change the value to true if the data has local trends for certain time periods. The summary results tell us that the absolute causal effect is 20.64, which is the same as the true causal impact. The 95% confidence interval for the absolute causal effect is -29.67 to 69.45, which is slightly narrower than the confidence interval from the default values. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about causal inference, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.